Hello and welcome to Global Topics. My name is Dr. Mike Krasanik and I'm the Executive Director of the Center for International Engagement here at Bridgewater State University in Massachusetts. Global Topics is a series of programs designed to highlight the research work of our distinguished faculty. We're pleased to have with us today Dr. Kyung-shick Choi from our Criminal Justice Department, who has done extensive work on the very sad problem of human trafficking throughout the world, but particularly in Korea as it impacts the United States. So welcome, Dr. Choi.
Oh, thank you so much for having me.
Dr. Choi, I'd just like to have you tell our viewers briefly a little bit about your research. What have you done, where have you done it, and what results have you come up with?
As we know, human trafficking is a serious and growing, growing transnational problems. According to the United Department of State, approximately between 600,000 and 800,000 people are being trafficked across the international borders on an annual basis. It is a serious problem. And unfortunately, identifying true problems and conveying empirical evidence within human trafficking issues are known to be greatly challenging. This research was sponsored by Korean Institute of Criminology. Dr. Kyung-shick Choi at UMass Lowell, he initiated this human trafficking research, and also director from the KIC sponsor, and also he was co-author, and I worked with this project for almost 1 year, and January 2009 to December 2009. We went actually inside of the human trafficking sites, which include like massage parlors and the various sex trading establishment in New York City.
In New York City,
yes.
Okay.
And because many people and the human trafficked women actually coming from the U.S., of course, like they stop by the Japan, and that's the kind of the first transit nation, and they move to Canada, and or like Mexico, and then finally come to the
U.S. So they come from Korea through a number of places and eventually end up in New York City.
Yes. Okay. And so because like New York City is close to us, and so we focus on the East Coast area. And the simple definition of the human trafficking is a worldwide form of exploitations in which men, women, and children are being bought and sold and held against their wills or slave-like conditions. However, the term of trafficking is very broad and also probably it's kind of unclear in the criminology or literature. Mm-hmm. And so we utilized United Nations terminology and by reflecting their key elements.
Mm-hmm. So it's not just women, it's also children and men as well. So I mean, there are a number of people across the board who are being affected by this problem.
Yeah, that's general term. And but since we focused on the human trafficked women and who works in the sex establishment, and so we looked at the women who actually forced to transfer to different location, and also if the women are confiscated their passports, and also if they kind of forced to work in, they were restricted in the freedom of movement, mm-hmm. and if they worked in extensive hours, mm-hmm. and so we categorized as a human trafficked women.
So they're almost like slaves then, one could say, right? I mean,
exactly.
They have no capability of escaping or going anywhere else because they're controlled by their handlers, so to speak.
That is true because they have very limited English proficiency, mm-hmm. and limited education, and also especially like the immigration status, and most of them were undocumented, and so sometimes they utilize the tourist visa, and also they cannot really go out because they cannot really speak English, and so also the owner of the establishment confiscate their passport and they cannot really go anywhere. And so it's they regularly rotated in the different states and different cities. And so they are pretty much locked in the loom. And
what is being done to try to end this scourge here of human trafficking? Are police departments working? Are there international organizations? What is being done to stop this?
Yeah, since this is a transnational crime and federal law enforcement agencies, they're working on all the cases. Mm-hmm. And the problem of that is they cannot stop because they keep coming and from the different nation and throughout the different routes. Mm-hmm. And rather than just focusing on maybe raids and or like a aggressive enforcement, I think it's important to share the information between South Korea and the U.S. Mm-hmm. And also they need to examine specific patterns of the victimization, and then so we can work together. Mm-hmm. Then collective work is the key in order to stop these problems.
So you are still working on this grant and probably will publish some works associated with this grant. Is that fair to say?
Yes, and because our current research centrally focuses on East Coast area. Mm-hmm. So next project, and we're working on the entire U.S., and mm-hmm. definitely we will cover the West Coast, mm-hmm. and especially Los Angeles and San Francisco area. And this one was done in New York City, and so we want to expand the sites to the Atlantic City.
Cities.
And also the Atlanta, city of Atlanta, that have significant
problems. Probably New York City is the hub on the East Coast, is that true, where there's most of this human trafficking going on?
Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And in Los Angeles, probably the largest on the West Coast, is
yes.
that you suspect?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
What about our own, we're in Massachusetts, what about our own Boston?
Oh, Massachusetts, we have a very strict laws, and so we are very fortunate to have a strong law, and so now we haven't found any, so far, like based on our research, we haven't found any specific problems. Mm-hmm. And but I know, and we have a problem in Providence area and the Rhode Island.
Okay.
And so Rhode Island is a very interesting site, and because they recently illegalized and prostitution, they was legal, okay. and a couple of years ago. Mm-hmm. So they switched their statutes, and that may cause maybe significant problem.
Professor Choi, Kyung-shick Choi from our criminal justice system, I want to thank you for sharing your research on human trafficking on our Global Topics program. I think it's been very informative to our viewers, and we wish you well with your research. So thank you for coming on our show.
Oh, thank you. My pleasure.